Hello everyone! Category 3 has become a tag for all kinds of horror and exploitation films from Hong Kong. The real meaning of Category 3 is that it's actually a rating system, but for foreign fans of the darkest side of cinema, Cat 3 has become a stamp for the violent and gritty. The movie I'm talking about today is one of the most early infamous ones that I remember reading about when I was younger and started to become familiar with horror from all parts of the world. I am Torstein from CinemaTerror, and this is the 1992 film Dr. Lamb. The story in Dr. Lamb is based on the real-life serial killer Lam Kor Wan, who was arrested in 1982 for the murder of four women. If that sounds familiar to you, then it might be because I have previously reviewed another film based on this horrific case, which was the 1985 film Hong Kong Butcher. In Dr. Lam, we start up with an opening scene, showing a small glimpse of the childhood of Lam Goh-Yu. I guess this scene is supposed to tell us how he ended up being such a violent bastard, but it only shows how he was exposed to a few sexualized situations at an early age, without bothering to go any further into the topic. We then cut to the present day, where Lam Goh-Yu has grown up to become a young man. He still lives with his family in a small apartment, if that's what you can call their small flat, and he makes a decent living working as a taxi driver. He takes advantage of his occupation for his murderous lust, and has a special hatred towards the drunken women who do not show off the type of behavior that he believes are respectable in a ladylike manner. His days as a serial killer is ending, however, as police detectives capture him while he tries to retrieve some printed photographs that he had taken of his victims. What follows is the police trying to get the story out of him, using every brutal method possible. When they make his family turn on him, Lam finally gives up and delivers all the horrific details of his bloody, violent acts that made him known to the world as Dr. Lamb. Well, that's not exactly correct, as his name is Lam and not Lamb, and he's absolutely not a doctor. Dr. Lamb sounds better than Taxi Driver Lamb, even though it was a missed opportunity to present it as a ripoff of Taxi Driver. Lamb is played by Simon Yam, who is a respectable and great Hong Kong actor. His performance here is what makes Dr. Lamb a good movie. He's creepy, nasty, and everything you can want from a serious, devilish serial killer in a Category 3 movie. We don't get to go into his psyche that much though, but considering that it's based on a real-life killer, it's not necessarily something I needed from the film either. What you want from a movie like this is to transform into the darker parts of human nature. When you press play, you are hoping for an hour and a half of disturbing content that will make you question what is wrong with us as humans and put you in a dark space. Because how else would you spend your Saturday nights, right? Dr. Lam doesn't quite manage to nail delivering such a dreadful experience. Most of the time is spent with the police investigators trying to unravel what this madman has done, and it slowly becomes revealed to them and us as viewers. Since he is already caught, there is no suspense and tension present in the film. It's all about waiting for the nasty, gruesome stuff, and when it comes around to it, Dr. Lam delivers. The film is not afraid to get ugly when it needs to, and there is a reason for why this one is known as one of the biggest Category 3 movies for foreign fans of the absurd subgenre that this has become. Many other Cat 3 movies of its time is brought down by the compulsive need to include silly humor, to lighten the tone I guess. Not to say that Dr. Lamb doesn't have its silly moments, it does, but since everything is so sweaty and foggy, it only makes the police detectives come off as goofy and not the entire situation. It's too grim of a plot for me to give out any laughter, regardless if the overweight police detective played by Kent Cheng is called Fat Bing, and body parts are thrown around, played off as a comedic situation. The performance that I enjoy the most goes to the lead detective Lee, played by Danny Lee, who also co-directed the film. He was great and would also play a police detective and co-direct another famous Category 3 movie with the Untold Story. And he would continue to play a detective in several other Category 3 movies as well, so I guess this was a role that he enjoyed doing in these nasty movies.
Oh
Lee co-directed Dr. Lam with another notable name in the early 90s Category 3 genre, Billy Hin-Shing Tang, or Billy Tang as he is regularly credited as. The amount of experience and talent that were both in front and behind the camera on this production obviously helped out and improved the quality, as you would expect a lot of newcomers to be involved in an exploitation film like Dr. Lam. Reading about the real-life killer is equally or more disturbing than the movie, and it became quite a big news story at the time. This awful human being strangled 4 women, dismembered them, and ate some of their intestines. The media ended up giving him the nickname of the Rainy Night Butcher. He was sentenced to death by hanging in 1983, but due to Hong Kong disbanding the death penalty a year later, his sentence was changed to life in prison. Dr. Lam would, according to IMDb, make over what equals today as $1.5 million at the Hong Kong box office. I have no clue how good of numbers that is in the Hong Kong market, but I can't imagine this being labeled as anything but a huge success for the producers. While the movie would be referenced in others, Dr. Lam, surprisingly enough, did not receive a sequel. Yeah, the story is done and over with in this one, but that's never stopped anybody before. Dr. Lam is not a movie for everyone, but for fans of the darker side of cinema, and especially Hong Kong Category 3 movies, it is an essential viewing. It's not among the best that they had to offer, and I would say that the untold story is similar and better, but Dr. Lam still delivers enough nasty bits to stand on its own and make you uncomfortable. I'm feeling like Dr. Lam deserves the good score of 3 out of 5. Who else out there has seen Dr. Lam? What were your thoughts on it, and how does it rank compared to the other Hong Kong Category 3 movies you've seen? Do you know of any unknown ones that I should check out and perhaps do a video about? Fill up the comment section below with all of your thoughts and recommendations. This video and future ones that are more on the violent side will be getting its own uncut version posted on my Patreon, as YouTube is not allowing very much of that stuff these days. So if you desire more guts and butts in my videos, then check that out. I hope you enjoyed this video on Dr. Lam. More stuff like this is on its way to my channel, so make sure you subscribe to keep yourself updated on all of my future content here on CinemaTerror. Thank you!